and thus we must all be vigilant to the evil amongst us, that which corrupts our nature, and through the subtleties of Satan precludes us from receiving the divine word of our Lord God. Let us pray.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread.
Amen.
Amen.
God bless you. God bless you.
Think on't, Minister. There's no doubt they'd make a fine match.
Your ears were scorched, I see. The shorters inquired after you.
How kind. You'll pardon me. I shall be there presently.
I've not come for absolution.
Were you seen?
No.
Mary.
Evelyn.
God bless you, Mary Chattox.
And you, Evelyn Whittle. Minister Gilbert.
God bless and keep you.
Minister, in words of your own mother.
You offer the ramblings of a mad woman.
I am as sane as you.
Silence thy tongue. It is no place for your reign. You vex us too much. I will not have it.
Damn you both to hell, then!
Days passed. She arrived home much delayed and bedraggled.
As though she were meddled with, dark markings across her limbs. Her moods are not natural. She has brought shame upon our families.
I feared you may be thirsty.
Dark tempers hath plagued her since.
She did also curse an elder.
Suspect you the devil's influence? For this and all his mercies, may God's holy name be blessed and praised through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Think you of Matthew Shorter?
I think not of him.
It is not right to remain a maid forever. It is no fate.
There is news.
Evelyn, you would do well to consider him. The Shorters are a fine family.
I am not yet a woman. It is true that Agnes has been accused.
It is a thorny matter. Her family are much afeard of her.
Of what are they afeard?
Something unknown plagues her mind and body.
Agnes toils many a long hour. Perchance she is ill.
It is no illness.
If not illness, consider you she hath been maltreated.
Evelyn?
Surely with adequate investigation, light can be shed upon the truth.
Witches must be trialed. Be she innocent, our Lord will protect her.
Father, be you quite certain?
Enough, Evelyn.
You swore to stay concealed.
You worry needlessly.
You are too reckless.
Too reckless? You do sound like a vexed wife.
Thank you.
What business have you?
I had to fetch the milk.
I noticed you did not attend the trial. Nor did Mary Chattox.
I have a little cheese safe to bring to you also.
Perhaps in a day or so.
Graciously strengthen their hearts, we pray, so that by keeping faith and pleasing you in all things, the Lord shall lead them happily to the sacrament of marriage. Through Christ our Lord, amen.
Amen. Amen.
I truly love thee.
Evelyn, go back to sleep.
Look upon me.
I must return.
Let us run, please.
You will awaken soon. I've not much time.
Evelyn. Intend you always to rove between his bed and mine?
No. This must end, Mary.
She did not return home.
And with whom has she dishonored my son?
Evelyn!
Have you no shame? Their dalliance is plain.
'Tis but a friendship.
She hath made a cuckold of my son! Her sin has overstepped the mark.
I do love her.
She hath been bewitched. Enchanted by this foul creature.
It isn't true.
Enough, witch!
I'm no more of a witch than Agnes!
The sister, she knows not what she does!